So yesterday we have studied that part where Antonio was speeding in front of Shylock. Now let us see today what is going to be Antonio's attitude towards Shylock. One thing is for sure, Antonio may be a bad human being, may be a common man, may be proud, but one thing we have to accept that he is a true nationalist. He loves his country from the core of his heart. That we can't deny. So that we are going to witness in this very scene, in the end of this scene. Let us make a fair assessment of this very scene. So here you go, here you start.
So we'll start from that very part where we ended last day. Shylock left the scene here. And who are left here? Salerno. Antonio and the gaoler, Salerno. It is the most impenetrable guard that have ever kept with human or men. Impenetrable means intolerable. That means who can't be tolerable. Means who can't be, who can be accepted. Instead of tolerated, I'll write accepted. Car means dog that ever kept with human. Kept means live together. Human means human society. So, according to him, Shylock is the most unaccepted, who cannot be accepted kind of dog. Is a kind of dog who has ever lived in human society. I'd like to remind you, just back Shylock said, since I'm a car, I'll take your flesh. So, since Shylock is called cur or dog many a times by Antonio and his friends, so obviously being a dog, he'll take the revenge. Antonio, let him alone. Let him alone means let him go. I'll follow him no more. Here follow means request him no more with bootless fear. Bootless mean meaningless. Prayers or futile prayers. So what we have got here? That many a times Shylock gave loan to different people of Venice. And as a result, they often fail to repay the money to Shylock. And Shylock, being cruel, stone-hearted person, was ready to take penalty from them. Now, what Antonio used to do, Antonio used to save those people. How? By providing them money so that they can repay Shylock. So in that case, Shylock could not take the extra penalty that he would take. And further, those people were left free. That is why Shylock is extremely angry upon Antonio. Salerno, I am sure the Duke will never grant his forfeiture to hold. Grant means allow this penalty. Forfeiture means penalty. To hold means to be successful. So the Duke will not allow this penalty or this forfeiture to be successful. This is impossible that the Duke would do that. This is Salerio's opinion. But I think, and we know very well, that Duke will not do that. So as Antonio says here, the Duke cannot deny the course of law. Course of law means the rules and regulation. The Duke cannot deny the rules and regulation. The commodity that the strangers have with us in Venice. The community means rights. That the strangers means the Jews, have with us in Venice, if be denied, it will much impeach the justice of the state. Now, the Jews enjoy liberty and rights there in Venice, just like the Christian. And if it is denied, there will be a huge chaos in Venice. People will start making question about the jurisdiction of Venice. It will much impeach the justice of the state. That means that will surely raise question about the justice or jurisdiction of the state. Since that the trade and profit of the city, the business of the city consisted of all nations, are related to the business of the city is related to all the countries. Therefore go. These griefs and losses have so baited me. Baited means tortured or disturbed me. That means Antonio is already tortured or disturbed due to all these losses. And here losses mean the economical losses he has due to the drowning of the ship. That I shall hardly spare. Spare means lose. A pound of flesh to my flesh tomorrow to my bloody creditor. Here bloody means bloodthirsty. To my bloodthirsty creditor. Oil gauler on. On means take me back to the jail. Pray God Bassanio come to see me. Pay his debt and then I care not. What is the debt that Bassanio has? The debt is a last meeting. A last meeting that Antonio demands from Bassanio. So here we can understand Antonio has totally submitted himself into the hands of fate. He is well aware of the fact that the Venetian law is very strict, and even the Duke, being so much affectionate to Antonio, changes the rule, then it will be a great question mark on the Venetian jurisdiction. People will surely raise question about the law, secularism, liberty and other systems of Venice. Since Venice during that period of time was well connected to the different parts of country, so entire world will come to know about such ill act that goes against the jurisdiction and the judicial system. So it cannot be done with force. Further, what you have seen here, Antonio respects the Venetian law. He was born here and he pays and he has a great respect towards the jurisdiction and the legal system. He can't allow such kind of ill act. So what we have found here, Antonio totally submissive. Such Antonio we have never seen in the drama. For the first time we are finding Antonio in such submissive condition. So if you may summarize the scene, what we have found, that Shylock being too much rigid, not ready to change the concept, the ideals that he has installed within himself. Even Antonio, who had been so strict, prominent and confident throughout the drama, is pleading in front of Shylock, requesting him to leave him for the last time. But Shylock did not listen. Instead, he reminded him of the bond of 3,000 ducats and a pound of flesh. Further, what we have seen here, the gaoler stood responsible for taking Antonio out, and Antonio ultimately told the gaoler to take him to the place where he is supposed to be. So, hope this will not cause much problem. This scene is smaller in size, but does have a great importance, since we can say this is the downfall of Antonio due to his overwhelming ambition. And here the static character that he used to possess has totally got over. So here ends the scene. Thank you very much.